40 tons of methyl isocyanate gas leaks from a tank at a Union Carbide plant on what was otherwise a quiet night. 8,000 people died within 2 weeks, and over 5 lakh people were exposed to the gas, and some thousands of people still continue to suffer. And I'm talking about the Bhopal gas tragedy, one of the worst industrial disasters to have taken place in the history. The disaster happened in 1984, but the tragedy still continues. And very recently, a campaign had been launched with an aim to bring Dow Chemical to justice by making them appear in a court in Bhopal. To talk more about this campaign, we're joined today by Rachna Dhingra, a social activist working in Bhopal alongside with the survivors of the Bhopal gas tragedy. Rachna, thank you for being on the show today.
Thank you for having me.
Can you explain what this campaign is about that was recently launched, and why you think this time around that Dow Chemical can be made to appear in the court in Bhopal?
Yes. So there has been a criminal case going on against Union Carbide Corporation USA and Warren Anderson since 1987. Since 1992, both of these, one individual and one corporation, has been absconding. That basically means that the Indian court wants them to appear, and notices have been sent, and they have not appeared, and they have been declared absconders or fugitives from justice. So in, after the merger with Union Carbide in 2001, we moved an application in the court saying that Dow Chemical is claiming to be the 100% owner of Union Carbide. So we should send a notice on why it did not make its 100% subsidiary Union Carbide appear in the criminal court case. So the court agreed, and a notice was sent. To cut the long story short, now four notices have been sent by the Bhopal court to Dow Chemical Company USA asking for its appearance in the Bhopal court in the last 2 years. And all these notices have been sent by the court to the Home Ministry and then to the U.S. State Department, who is supposed to serve these notices to Dow Chemical. So even though Dow Chemical knows about the existence of these notices, they have not appeared because they have technically not been served by the U.S. Department of Justice. So this whole campaign is about putting pressure on Department of Justice, of the U.S. government, which has a treaty with the Indian government called the Mutual Legal Assistance Treaty, in which the whole job is to, if there is someone, a foreign accused is needed by the either government, the other government will help them. So instead of helping Indian government in issuing the notice to Dow Chemical so that they appear, it seems like the U.S. Department of Justice is assisting Dow Chemical in ensuring that they do not appear. So this is a petition that Bhopal survivors and supporters have started on this whitehouse.gov site, which is an initiative of the Obama administration, in which we are seeking 100,000 signatures within 30 days, asking, and the question asked is that the U.S. Department of Justice enforce the law and serve the notice to Dow Chemical so they can appear in the ongoing criminal case in Bhopal, India.
Mm-hmm. Now, apart from serving this court notice, has the Indian government officially taken this up with the U.S. Government at any point in during this 3 decades of history of the Bhopal gas disaster?
Well, very little initiative has been taken, but we do know in the last couple of years for this notice, the CBI has shown, quite a bit of, initiative in this. So the U.S. State department did respond to one of the notices just before Prime Minister Modi's visit last year and asked some very ridiculous questions. Anyways, all those questions were answered by the CBI, and that was back in November 2015. And from then on, another notice has been, two more notices have been sent, and the state government has been totally silent. So it's not that the Indian government has not taken any initiative, and most importantly, there is a treaty between these two countries precisely for this reason, that if a foreign individual or a corporation accused is in the other country, each government is supposed to provide assistance. And so it is very sad that the U.S. State Department is not only not providing that assistance to the Indian government, but is providing assistance to Dow Chemicals, which is wanted by the Bhopal court.
Mm-hmm. Now, one of the reasons Dow Chemicals has always stated, why they are not sort of responsible for this disaster was that they only mm-hmm. inherited the, all the profits or the good that came out of Union Carbide and Dow Chemical merger, but not their liability. So they sort of took over all the assets, but not the liabilities. Now, are you aware of any industrial laws that sort of enforce that you cannot simply merge or take over a company without wholly accepting their liabilities as well?
First of all, Dow themselves did it. I mean, if you look at their merger clause, they specifically set aside money for the Union Carbide victims of asbestos. They set aside money for that in U.S. But when it comes to Bhopal, they have a completely double standard, you know. And there are many, many laws in terms of the polluter pays principles. Yeah, so it's the company that pollutes will have to pay for that. And you cannot just take over assets of a corporation and leave all the liabilities behind. These were liabilities that were not settled. These are liabilities that are continuing. The environmental liability is a continuing liability. They have not done the cleanup. They have not compensated people who have been damaged due to drinking of or consumption of contaminated water. You know, the criminal liability has not been settled. And in this, we are not saying that the criminal liability is getting transferred to Dow. The court is merely asking to appear and tell us why it will not make its 100% subsidiary appear in the Bhopal court. So it is absolutely ridiculous that the corporations accept that they will take over all the assets and just leave all its liabilities, especially if those liabilities are in the poor countries.
Right, right. And I believe there have been also talks about a merger, a potential merger with Dow between Dow Chemical and DuPont. Now, how much do you think this petition, is at stake given this recent development between these two companies?
Yeah, so one thing that the shareholders of both corporations will be alarmed with is when a corporation is going to face a criminal case. And this is exactly why Dow is being requested by the Bhopal court to appear, because this isn't a matter of a criminal case. So I think both SEC, the Security and Exchange Commission, we are going to be writing to them about this as well. And, DuPont has its own set of liabilities, and Dow has its own set of liabilities. So this is just going to be another whale for both of them to escape their corresponding liabilities. So this case is pretty important in that, because it should worry the shareholders of both corporations that Dow is potentially involved in an ongoing criminal case in Bhopal.
Now, you mentioned that the liabilities have not been settled, the disaster site has not been cleaned up. Could you talk about the situation on the ground actually in Bhopal, in and around Union Carbide plant? What are the living conditions like, and what is the situation of the plant itself?
Yeah, situation is pretty bad. I would say things have actually gotten worse in the last years. If you look at the issue of just the people exposed to the gas disaster, we have more than 100,000 people that continue to be chronically sick due to exposure-related illnesses, and we do not know how to treat people because Carbide and now Dow refuses to release the toxicology of gases that were released on that night and the research that they carried out on exposure to MIC in Carnegie Mellon. So there is a big health disaster happening here. Then there is issue of contamination. About 22 communities in and around the Union Carbide factory have been contaminated. It's the Supreme Court of India that has demanded that from the government that people get clean drinking water. But the contamination is there. It is spreading. Right now it's affecting 50,000 people. If it's not cleaned up, it will affect more and more people every day. Then we have a new generation of children that are coming up with all sorts of birth defects whose parents were either exposed to the gas or whose parents drank contaminated water for several years. So, you know, and there is a system which has totally failed. There is contamination and there is no health care for them. There is people suffering from gas exposure-related illnesses and we don't know how to treat them. And most importantly, legally, the precedent is really, really sad that for killing 25,000 people and injuring more than 500,000 and contaminating bodies of more than 50,000 people, not a single corporation or individual has gone to jail. And both of the corporations, Union Carbide and Dow Chemical, are doing, Dow Chemical is doing business as usual. And this is the world, not only the world's worst industrial disaster, but one of the world's worst corporate massacres. You know, and this continues, and it just gives the signal that corporations can get away with murder.
Mm-hmm. Now, in light of what you just said about, you know, more than 50,000 people are facing, lack of safe drinking water, and even the site is also not getting cleaned up now. Is it not the local government's responsibility as well to sort of intervene and do what's required while it tries to indict Dow Chemical and bring it to justice?
Yeah, absolutely. And the clean drinking water part has been addressed by the local government. It took us almost 15 years to get it, but now people living here have clean drinking water. But what's the point? Because as long as the contamination is not cleared up, more people are going to have problems with contaminated water. And yes, it is, so government has to basically do the cleanup and then build Dow Chemical, but our government has not been able to do it. We do not have expertise in this country to deal with such kind of contaminated sites, and most importantly, there is no political will to, our Prime Minister talks about cleaning up India, and yet Bhopal being one of the worst contaminated places, he has no vision or no real desire to address the ongoing problems in Bhopal.
Okay. Now, switching back to the ongoing campaign and actually petition, have you spoken to the survivors about this petition? What do they think about the possibility of Dow Chemical appearing in the Bhopal court? What is their view of this?
Well, they feel very strongly that it needs to appear. And what is interesting is that Dow Chemical appears in this civil case filed against them by the government of India for more compensation. But when it comes to criminal case, they are not appearing. So they cannot pick and choose on which forum they would like to appear. That's called forum shopping and totally inappropriate. But, victims have been, survivors have been part of the struggle for very long, and they know it's not an easy thing to get Dow to appear, but they are determined, and that's why we have this campaign that we are hoping that we will be able to at least shame the U.S. government in saying that we are not saying anything out of ordinary. We are saying enforce the law, enforce this treaty that you have with the U.S. government, and serve the notice to Dow Chemicals to appear.
And is this campaign being run by a single organization, a collaboration of multiple organizations? Could you give some insight into that as well?
Yes, it's being run by International Campaign for Justice in Bhopal, which has survivor organizations included and many other, and there are many other organizations that are supporting this campaign, you know, most likely Greenpeace, Pesticide Action Network, IPEN, Code Pink, the Yes Men, hopefully Amnesty as well. So there is, but we need a lot more support from ordinary individuals who believe that what happened in Bhopal was wrong and it should not be repeated. And people and corporations who did this should be held accountable for that.
And how do you suggest the any of our listeners or anyone else supporting this campaign can actually sign the petition and maybe interested in volunteering? How do you suggest they go about doing that?
They just have to go to the whitehouse.gov site and search for Bhopal's petition. It's basically, the petition is called Uphold International Law, Stop Shielding Dow, and sign on the petition. Once they sign, they'll get an email from White House, and they have to confirm the signatures. Only way the signature will be counted if you confirm the signature. So we need 100,000 signatures in 30 days. It's already been a week. We have less than 10,000. So we really need to get moving in order to get the remaining signatures.
All right. There you go, listeners. So you can go to whitehouse.gov, search for Uphold International Law, or you can also go to the Bhopal.net, which is the ICJB, International Campaign for Justice in Bhopal's website. Again, it's Bhopal.net, and you should see the link for the petition there. And Rachna, thank you very much for your time. Any lasting thoughts for our listeners?
That justice in Bhopal is not just an issue of Bhopal or people of Bhopal. It is an issue of people all over the world who believe in justice, who believe in human rights, who believe in a safe environment for children and for all. Because right now we have a very sad precedent that corporations can do this. Pollute, kill, and then leave without any kind of liability. Let's come together and change this and force Dow Chemical to appear in the Bhopal court. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Rachna. And listeners, once again, as Rachna pointed out earlier, this is not just the worst industrial disaster. It's also one of the worst corporate massacres. And this is the time to speak up. So please go to whitehouse.gov or bhopal.net and do the needful. Thank you once again for joining us, and good luck with the campaign, Rachna.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.